Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Tevaron here, and welcome to Maize. I don't know a ton about this game, except that it is super weird, have heard it is very cool, and not terribly long, so I think I'm going to try to jam this sucker out and just put up the VODs on the weekend, and hopefully that will be okay with everyone. Because I really want to play this, and if I'm going to be playing it, I might as well be recording it. So without further ado, let's see what the buzz is all about. Okay, so apparently we've been tripping acid. At least that's what it appears like to me. Psychedelic intro and then stalks of corn, or maize, I guess, as is the game's name, walk down the path ahead of us. How did we get here? Can we interact with things? We've got some cattails. There's a dock. It's kind of decrepit and falling apart. Can't get to it in any event, at least not at the moment. Can we go over here? No. Looks like there's nothing for it but to follow our corny leaders. Looks like they're shedding. Unfortunate. That's a problem a lot of corn has in its later years. Nothing to be ashamed of course. Just one of those facts of corn life. Keep looking for ways to get into this. Looks like it's just this one wide path. With the occasional fence. Silo? Yes. Yeah, there's water that way for sure. What the? Alright, there's a female symbol. Great. Don't know what that's about. There's a house that way. And there's a box with flowers on the bottom. What is this? Is this a bunker? When the pointing hand icon appears, click the left mouse button to interact. Sure. Alright. So we've got a hand. Oh, it even says that. A slot for a hand. A slot for a key. Looks like it's got a double helix sort of DNA symbol there, and a circular slot kind of looks like a clay pigeon or a frisbee. So do we need to find those things to open this door? That would be my first guess. Escape or P to enter the pause menu. Oh, okay, thank you. Very much like it when games tell you how to control them. And you don't have to just stumble around on your own. I was about to make a quote about two paths divided in a cornfield, but apparently it's really just one path. Is this? No, this one is two paths. But this one dead ends very quickly. Q does absolutely nothing. Well, I mean, I haven't pressed it yet, but thank you. I guess we know now that it does absolutely nothing. Wonder if I press it, if the game will say something about it. Kind of a Stanley Parable-esque thing to do. Oh. somebody's been receiving visitors here, probably conducting some very important corn type business. Grab English muffin. Oh, I think I just saw more corn slide around that corner. Apparently we did a great job picking up this English muffin. Items you can use will be added to your inventory. Story items will be added to your folio. Okay. How do we access that? I? No. F? No. Is it in the pause menu? No. Ah, spacebar. Welcome note. A note, lazily scribbled, includes a stock greeting and encourages the reader to enjoy the complimentary snack on the desk. Notes to the reader to mind the boxes, and also says open the big door and we'll probably say hello. I don't know if that's something I actually want. Looks like that's one of 75 readable things. What's this sign say? We'll be back in some obscure amount of minutes. Well, this English muffin doesn't really have... Oh, okay, so right-click just tells us what we're holding. Doesn't really have the circular indentations as far as I could see, but maybe this is what goes in the round place on the door, so we're going to go try that. If I can remember how to get back, not this way. Back to where we were. And of course, it's a maze within the maze. This way? Maybe. Seems further back than I remember, or maybe I've gotten turned around and we're just going to come back out where the table is. We are. Alright, try this again. Alright, that was better. Just keep to the right on the way back. Okay, so it's not. Can we, like, put this away somehow to where I'm not just holding it out in front of me like an imbecile? I don't know. At least it hasn't told me how to do such a thing yet, so I shall persevere. This way. Alright, so we're back at the table. Nothing in that drawer. Can't seem to open these drawers, so let's press on. Press E to examine your equipped item for clues on how to use it. English muffin. Hard as granite. This muffin is most definitely nowhere fit for consumption. Despite how much you try, all you've done is given yourself a headache. That's unfortunate. So E examines. Kind of a strange little patch of corn there. There's things over there. I want to check out this little patch. Maybe it's just an extrusion. And it is. Fog effects made it look like it was a little bit separate, but apparently not. And a tree stump. I have a little grove here. Windmill that way or up here? I guess that way. Ooh, nice god rays. Well, looks like the path to the windmill is blocked. We got office supplies and mega oranges. Sure. Okay. Well, we shall come back when we have a paper shredder or a match, I suppose. Or some other way to get past the boxes because our character is apparently unable or unwilling to just knock them down. Press the spacebar. Yeah, I've looked at the story items. I figured that out on my own, though I do still appreciate you telling me how to do it. That way to the bunker. Little signs painted everywhere. That's weird. What is this statue doing? And there's something on the ground. Yeah, I mean, call me crazy, but this seems kind of out of place. And what's this? A broken shovel handle. Equip inventory items by using the scroll wheel or the 1 and 2 keys. Ah. Alright, so we can just put them away with the mouse wheel. All right. This is, again, the weight of the windmill, but once again, it is blocked. Anything over in these little corners? Thought I saw something light up. I guess it was just light glinting off a maize leaf. Well, that's all for this little area. I suppose we can go into the house, but I want to look around out here first. Little, like, chicken coop over there? That's what it looks like. Got a little owl hanging in the window. Storm doors to the cellar. Oh, can we, trip that lock? Not with the muffin or the shovel handle. What is... broken hubcap. Great. Probably to that rusted car we saw out front. Ah, we can go in here. Okay, so it is a chicken coop. No food and no chickens. A key, though. Farmhouse key. Well, thank you for telling me that that's what that is. I do appreciate it, so I'm not just wondering. Okay. Hello, water pump. Can we get some water? No. So what goes off in this direction? I still have not really pressed the Q key. Just a few times after you told me I couldn't. I don't know if that counts. Maybe it's just scripted. Hello? A mediocre rock. Well, and it's in the folio? This is a rock you found near an outhouse. You don't know why you have it. It is absolutely mediocre in every possible way. Its name is Chauncey. Well, you know what? At least we have a friend, right? Right. Wonder what it will say when we examine this. Your mind explodes with the possible uses of this item, but you settle on key to unlock a nearby farmhouse, and never think of any other possibility again. Cool. It's kind of neat writing. What about the shovel? Completely useless for shoveling dirt, but helpful if you wanted to tip something over. You immediately think of the wardrobe on the second floor of the farmhouse because you didn't particularly like how it looked at you and would like to ruin its day. Alright, so apparently we should have found the wardrobe on the second floor before we found this thing, but, you know, whatever. I do what I want. And story narrative be damned. Not really. Oh, hello. A rusty nail jammed in a wall. So we need something to get that out. Can we pry it out with... no. Probably can't English muffin it. And can't key it either. I didn't really think we could. Well, we'll go back and look on the other side of the farmhouse because there were some things painted there. Wonder if it's the corn painting all of these signs on things. And where did they get the white paint? Okay. Nice roses. Wait. Okay, just corn shucks. Oh, this is... gotcha. Okay, I see. So I guess this is what's painted here. The barn? Okay, well there's a side porch there. Let's go... oh, we can't get to the barn. Path is blocked that way too. I assume that these will open up at some point. We can open the door, but is there anything out here? It's a very nice little wraparound porch despite... the overall decrepit condition of the actual house itself. Okay, yeah, I mean, cool. Is that, it's just a speck of light. I thought it was a note. Can't turn on any light, so that's really creepy. Don't know what that looks like when it's fully lit, but it's rather disturbing in the dark. Thing over here is highlighted. An invoice for a carved wooden statue. Is that the one we saw outside? I thought it was stone, but I guess it was carved out of the tree itself. An invoice for a commissioned wooden statue. Cost is in the hundreds of thousands. Items on the list include chopping down a large old oak tree, carved statue out of oak tree, and hospital bills for injury sustained chopping down oak tree. Right. So, that's expensive. It says hundreds of thousands, but that looks like 2.5 million to me. So, yeah, that's a very expensive wooden statue. Much more expensive than I would have garnered something of that size would be to make. Guess it depends on who you get to do it. All right. Well, there's some old galoshes. And a reindeer hat. Haha. Because John Deere is, you know, a trademark and stuff. A chess set. And a wrapper for some fast food and something else highlighted. Night Danger. A Mick Murphy Mystery by Reginald P. Higabottom. Having no talent at the genre, the author mistakenly revealed the murderer's identity on the first page and spent the rest of the novel outlining a story about the detective buying a pair of pants. Aha! Uh-huh. Great! How did he get published? Or I guess maybe self-publishing is the thing, or had connections with a publishing house of some sort. Nothing seems to be standing out further in here. Oh my god. So, that's a rather disturbing parody of American Gothic. It looks positively bone-chilling. That's okay, I guess. Is that the same person that's in the American Gothic parody? And for that matter, is that the same guy that the statue's made of? That looks like it's a parody of something too, like a Scotchman. It looks like the Braveheart sword. And wolves and lions around him? Stranger and stranger. There's things to interact with in here. What's this? A fruit crate. All right. Despite what the name would suggest, this crate was specifically used to hold a large number of pine cones in order to start a collection. The collection currently sits at zero. I don't know how we're supposed to know that, but apparently that is the truth of the matter. Pizza boxes. What's this? Rancid corn oil. Why do we want rancid corn oil? Though the smell is strong enough to overcome a herd of yaks, you could use it to loosen something you need to remove. For some reason, an image of a gloved hand pops into your head, leading directly to you walking straight into a wall. Okay. Something with a gloved hand? Great. Everything's just becoming crystal clear suddenly. Yeah. A sausage grinder. Something is jammed inside. Well, I'm not sticking my hand in that. Need something to get it out. Maybe some pliers. This is a well-stocked pantry, if it's not all spoiled. See to crouch and see again to not crouch. These potatoes look very humanoid in their shapes. What's the... Oh, hello. Yes, the unlocked secret door is much less secret. And I guess this is it. Okay, so we're going into the cellar. We can stop crouching, I would assume. What is going on here? And where is that walking corn we have seen twice now? And that is the one who was the other character in the American Gothic parody up there. What are these two about? Are they actually people that are here? Missing a fuse. Can we use something from our inventory as a fuse? Not yet. We would need something metal. Or an actual fuse. Though I hesitate to suggest that a real fuse is the solution in a game such as this. Oh, okay, up to here. And now we can get out this way. Anything else down here? Look up at the ceiling. It's a light ballast. Oh yeah, space doesn't jump. Space opens the folio. Okay, I don't see anything else that is highlighted as interactable. Let's go up here and finish exploring this level before we venture back out. There may be some areas that have opened up now, but... Alright, there's some stuff in here. Old bathtub. A bathtub plug. This particular plug fits perfectly into the bathroom sink on the first floor of the farmhouse. It is also a talking plug, but due to a bad case of laryngitis, you will never know that. Thank you. I am kind of disappointed we won't get to hear the plug speak, but apparently we immediately found where it goes. And there is... nail clippers. Okay. Vigilant as you are when it comes to personal hygiene, the only two things these clippers will do for you are grip something lodged in a wall and give you a 100% tetanus guarantee. That's it. Yeah, they are in horrible, horrible shape. An old sink. Can we pull this thing out of here? No. Ah, I bet these are to get the nail out of the outhouse. Something can be done here. Okay. Well, we got it on the first try, but why did we pour rancid corn oil into the sink? Maybe we're making a rancid stew. Can we open this? No. Guess it's the front door or the cellar to get out. Well, let's go and see if we can get that nail out of the outhouse. I think it was past the chicken coop. The best my memory can recall. Haha. Alright, nail clippers. And yes, and we lost the clippers, so now we just have a nail. Fair enough. And the story behind the nail is... for some reason, the first thing that pops in your head is that it would be a good conductor of electricity, possibly as a fuse. You are very strange. Not so strange. We shall use it as a fuse. Albeit it's a fuse that will not burn out, so it could be a fire hazard, so there is that downside. However, I'm not overly worried. It's not my house. Okay. Yes, I know it's against safety regulations. Restored power to farmhouse. It is slightly less dark than it was before. Huzzah! So now we can go see if those paintings are just as creepy as they appeared in the poor lighting. Alright, still the sausage grinder. Don't have a way to get whatever's lodged in there out. Alright, that thin guy, the Whistler's Mother parody there. No, it's still pretty creepy. I mean, a bit less so, I suppose. It's kind of a sound coming. Is it this? A CD player. You pick up a CD. Good for you. A new path is open to you, to the barn and silo. All right. An old CD, its label faded, pressed on the first batch of CDs ever created. This brand was notoriously expensive and even more unreliable, making even the greatest of symphonies sound like something a concussed elephant would make while stumbling around a music shop. Great. Just what I wanted. Go away, inventory. So now that the lights are on, there are new things to interact with, apparently, as evidenced by the CD player there. Still just a fast food wrapper there. What is with all of these paintings? Nothing new seems available in here. Perhaps we should venture up the stairs. Though I wonder if that CD would fit in that circular thing on the building, the bunker type deal back there. Again, it doesn't have the concentric rings on it, but it is round. Okay. So a box needs to go there, maybe? A wobbly wardrobe. Can we use the handle in and of itself? We don't have a fulcrum. I guess that's maybe what the box is for. Yeah. That is what I would guess. That crate down there wasn't actually... Oh wait, we did pick it up, didn't we? I'm being an idiot. There we go. Lever it. Tipped wardrobe over with the broken shovel handle. And now we don't need this stuff anymore. Alright, we can go up there, but there's still stuff down here we have not looked at. Don't know if any of it matters. Haven't seen anything to interact with yet, besides the wardrobe. What about across the hall? Well, there's a picture of a parrot. At least it's not one of those creepy dudes. More fast food wrappers. Can we read what's on that? No. It's just something that starts with a B. Whatever. Maybe it's Polly's. Like from Rocky. Something on this. Excuse me. Sorry to bother you. A bobby pin. Well, that would do for perhaps picking a lock. Haven't seen a lock to pick. Unless it's the back door to the house, though why we would want to do that, I don't know. Just to get another exit. Alright, up we go. Something over there to interact with. Hello, creepy garden gnome. Ooh, stuff over here to interact with as well. This looks kind of like... What? These look very humanoid as well. Is this where the corn originated? These people were doing experiments to make humanoid plants? What the what? An item can be placed here. Don't think we have anything shaped like that, do we? No? A mallet? Alright, so now we have a hammer in search of a nail. Sure. We need to find something to pound. And there was something over here, right? What is that? A burnt lab report. Okay. Much of it can't be read, but the words abject failure appear several times. So does hurt feelings, sentient corn stalks, and why did we do this? Great. I see jerks as well down there at the bottom. Hmm. So are the experimenter's feelings hurt, or are the sentient corn's feelings hurt? Suppose that is the purpose of all of this. There's another sort of female symbol over there. What is the purpose of those? And there's a barn? Looks like there's two barns, maybe. And the silo. And, like, a reservoir? Okay, this is freaky. What is the deal here? Guess we follow the new paths. Can we pound this sausage grinder and get the stuck thing out of it? It seemed like a less than perfect tool for that. I would think you would want like some pliers or something. Which paths were it that opened up? The barn? Yes. And I think the silo. So let's go explore, shall we? Yes, I have discovered that. That is generally the key that you push to sprint in a first-person game. If you're stuck, remember to press E to examine your equipped items for clues. I have done all that. Oh, yeah, we didn't examine the mallet, did we? Smash something perfectly flat with this trusty tool. But remember, you can never unflatten things with this. It is the mallet's greatest weakness. Good to know.